Russian hits Tung Tian, who gets us underway here.
One love.
We're going to have a fairly partisan crowd here.
One all.
Nice shot there from Yuan Jiangnan.
So you can see the difference in the trajectory. The red side of the racket from Yuan Jiangnan, the backhand, is a spinny rubber, so she'll arc the ball. It's a more consistent shot, but not quite as flat and fast.
She's known for that high toss, isn't she, Yuan Jiangnan?
It's a generational thing. Her, Zhang Xiaona, yeah, this, you know, in China, the short pips forehand of pen holders, you'd see a lot of those. But yeah, she's got one of the highest tosses in the game.
It really is. It'll go out of frame.
Sure did.
But that can happen after we've built that all up.
It went out of everywhere. Hey, purple. It used to be blue. Actually, maybe it was the other way around. It was the old one that was purple first, and then it faded to blue. I thought it was just a French pride thing.
4-3-2.
In terms of that high toss, there are some advantages. Obviously, it's high risk. We see Hugo Calderano doing it as well. The ball comes into the racket with more speed, so you can generate more spin.
3-all.
And you can also make it less predictable for the receiver. Now, people often ask, is the receiver, should I watch the ball? No.
No.
Watch the racket. The racket is what determines the spin. The ball shouldn't have any spin, or not much, on the toss.
She just looked up there and shook her head. So she might rethink that, I wonder. Let's have a look. This is a nice angle for us to see. Nope.
4-3.
Well, she could have rethought it.
Yeah.
I think it is her serve. She might have tossed it slightly differently to avoid any lighting fixtures. While the Infinity Arena travels the world, it's a little bit different here and there, and understandably so.
3-5.
Now, I mentioned the backhand side of the racket for Yuan Jiangnan. On the black side, which she keeps on her forehand except for when she's serving, that has short pips, those little bumps, so the shots don't have as much spin, tough to rally with.
3-6.
So tell us about the advantage of having that short pips on that side.
Well, people just aren't used to it. Most people are training with someone who has the same rubber as Tung Jian does on both sides.
On both sides, right?
Yeah, I mean, the backhand there, the red side of the racket, that's a spinny, we call it inverted rubber, because the pips are inverted, turned inwards into the sponge. Man, Yuan Jiangnan talking about rethinking. She's going to be pretty clear about every decision she makes as best she can be.
7-4.
So you see there when she serves, she hits it with the red side of the racket, then she twiddles it, turning it around 180 degrees, and gets right back and ready to play with the short pips on the forehand for a flatter short stroke.
4-8.
Well, she's in a good position here, Yuan Jiangnan.
It's actually an incredibly uncommon style. Matthias Falk, one of very few men.
Another one does it, right? Yeah.
Right, but it's incredibly uncommon in this game, especially at the pro level.
5-8.
And why is that?
Well, there's just so much more security to being able to spin the ball and arc it to make sure it comes down.
8-6.
And the twiddling, I guess, to a layman looking at that just looks unwieldy as you have just so little time to react. I know these guys are obviously very good at it, but it would seem to just add a little bit more that you have to think about.
Watch the choppers from Ukraine play. It's unbelievable how fast they twiddle their rackets.
9-6.
And that's mid-rally. Like, sometimes there will be three twiddles from Tatiana Bielenko before the ball's even played back. But here, for Tung Jian, in the rally, as soon as the ball sits up a little bit, that hammer comes through from that flat forehand of Yuan Jiangnan.
She's got four game points now, Yuan.
Seven, 10.
One saved.
11-7. Game to Ian. One love.
Yeah, she's doing well. Apart from that one serve that didn't go quite the way she wanted, Yuan Jianan's been good on her serve.
That's part of the risk factor. I mean, I think she's been rewarded for every other one. You're right. Odds still good on the serve.
Love two.
Decent return as well from Zhang, wasn't it?
Stepped around, was getting back into position. Ball changes directions completely. Sorry, we got to pick up another passenger on the way.
One, two.
That's tough. Zhang Jian was on time for the meeting and everything. When she ordered the grab, it just wasn't part of the deal. But she quickly turned things around, much like the ball did the point before.
Two all.
Yeah, it was tight for a little bit as well in that previous game. And then Yuan just started to surge away.
Yuan Jianan is going to have a little bit more trouble if Zhang Jian keeps the ball low, spinny, and deep, which she has on the last point or two.
3-2.
But here, just a little bit of height, yeah. And that's the danger. When Duhoi Kim stopped Mima Ito from these kill shots, it was with deep, low spin early on in the point. Once Yuan Jianan takes the attacking role, it's tough to stop her.
2-4.
Yeah, just last month, Zhang Jian claimed her first Singapore Table Tennis Association Player of the Year award after strong performances at two major competitions last year. So she's on a bit of a high since then. She led a very young women's team to the quarterfinals of the team championships in Chengdu. And at the Commonwealth Games, she got two golds, a silver and a bronze. And you mentioned she's obviously looking at the SEA Games coming up and in Cambodia, and then the Asian Games later this year. But with that injury, sort of recovering from an injury.
These athletes are so good at either recovering or just making sure that it's sort of hidden, that it doesn't impede their ability to perform out here.
Four, five.
Well, she's now taking the lead here, Zhang Jian.
You see low to the net, spinny. This is what she needs to do. Again, without that spinny forehand rubber, Yuan Jianan requires a little bit more height on the ball for success.
Five all.
It was around this stage that she started to make a move in the last game. Yuan Jianan.
Five, six. Six all. Six, seven.
Oh, disappointment for Yuan Jianan there.
Eight, six.
Really nice to down the crowd. Enjoyed that one.
Not easy to withstand that flat hit kill shot. Yuan Jianan, watch her step around the corner, And like a shield, just holds that racket up, uses the wingspan, and exploits the opportunity cross court. Zhang Jian, well played.
Well, the momentum has shifted rapidly to Zhang Jian, who's now won 7 of the last 9. She was 2-4 down. 9-6 up here.
6-10.
And now she's got game points in hand. Next year, an Olympic year. It's a home Olympics, Yun Jianan. Love to be part of that, she said.
Saved
a couple of game points here.
It's tough to imagine she won't be part of that. I mean, Pritika Pavad.
Pavad, yeah.
But even still, after beating Chun Meng, after playing so well with Emmanuel Lebesson and mixed doubles, I mean, that's sort of what put her on the map. And Yuan Jianan has created a solo career. One-woman band out here, the women's singles.
10-9.
3 in a row.
And here's the timeout. The backhand is dangerously smooth. I think there needs to be some surprise to the forehand side.
4 in a row. Yuan Jianan has drawn level.
The surprise factor there was length. She got her to play the forehand and said, try and take this, but there's going to be an edge of the table in the way. And Yuan Jianan still made the shot. Impressive. Scary impressive.
Go to the backhand serve here now.
11-10.
It's another game point.
The tongue out of Yuan Jianan set it all for me. I mean, she really set it up with this parallel. You could see the fallback of Zhang Jian. That is understandable. Meme that. Webster's. Game point again.
So Zhang Jian has taken this second game.
One love.
But Zhang Jian wants to carry that momentum on into this third game. She was pushed really hard, wasn't she, by Yuan Jianan, who played well towards the end.
Love two.
She started well here, the Singaporean.
Zhang Jian moves incredibly well around the table. She's good mid-distance, too. At first glance, you might not realize that, but she's dangerous from a lot of places.
1-2.
I say that just because if Yuan Jianan can, in recent history, beat one of the two most unbeatable players in the game, Chun Meng. I mean, Chun Meng has no lack of support behind her, nor experience. Yet couldn't figure out the answer to get the best of Yuan Jianan. And Zhang Jian, both of these players, I mean, they have some time to study each other's game and prepare. First day, first round, you know, let's say the night before after the draw, okay, this is my opponent in this match. This is who I have to prepare my game for.
4-1.
Yeah, fantastic start here for Zhang Jian. Game 3.
Smart placement for me. Yuan Jianan, take a look here in the replay. One to the forehand, and as soon as Zhang Jian starts to pivot, Yuan Jianan goes wide to the forehand.
Three, four.
Good fast long serve here to pin Tung Jian on the crossover, catch her in between.
For all.
Yeah, I mean, Yanta Anand's a batter as well, isn't she?
She sure is, and she's just won 3 points in a row. Again, she's very calculated with the short pips on the forehand. She can only take so much risk with that flat trajectory shot.
5-4.
And one thing about the pips, if you've got sponge underneath that's a little bit thicker, the ball will sink in so you can spin a little bit more. And she's using that again to her advantage. Hey, we see you front row.
4-6.
This is seesawed, this third game.
This could, after all, be the pivot point of the match. In a best of five, whoever goes up 2-1 is going to have a massive advantage. Matches are quicker than they used to be, until the late rounds here anyway, when it becomes best of seven.
8-4.
Yeah, this is the drawback, right, that we talked about that can happen.
The high toss serve.
The high toss serve.
I think Tung Jian has done an incredible job starting in game two to really, say, focus on the receive and not be at too much of a disadvantage despite the excellent serves of Yuan Jianan.
8-5.
Well, don't discount her yet. I don't think she'll put up a fight. Play shots like that. Excellent from the French padlet.
How many times have we seen her just go down the line, pick out a shot parallel? I mean, not within reach, not with a taxi. That ball was just too perfect. Yuan Jianan making her way back in.
7-8.
Changing up the serve as well.
It'd be nice to have a timeout right about now.
Well, I've got Minister here, Edwin Tong, who's the Minister for Culture, Community and Youth, of which sports comes under. And he's certainly enjoying himself there, wearing the Singapore jersey as well. Getting right behind Tung Jian.
8-all.
There are other VIPs in attendance.
Excuse me, no towel.
No towel, of course, that's a cheeky little towel. Got the ambassador Sun Haiyan, as well the Chinese ambassador to Singapore, enjoying Singapore smash from the sweets.
9-8.
I like that the umpire Christoph Geiger was right on it. He's like, nope, no towel break, not now. I see you, can't do it now. Towel break allowed every 6 points.
You kind of alluded to the fact that he's a bit of a stickler with things, isn't he?
He's very detail-oriented, yeah.
8-10.
Ah, opportunity here for Tung Jian. 2 game points, as we know, that may not be enough. She was pushed all the way in that second game. Finally won it on the 6th game point. Some point.
How quickly she's able to change up that backhand placement, the direction there, Yuan Jianan.
Wow, we are back where we were in the second game at 10-all.
Singapore fans. China flag in there as well.
Yeah, a few Chinese flags.
You saw more than one?
I saw a couple.
Whoa, man.
So two clear points needed now for a winner.
11-10.
Jian Jianan, who has the edge here. It's Yen who takes this third game. And she was trailing. Wins four in a row. So Tung has to win this game to stay in the match.
Love long.
Have to try and force the issue there, Yen.
It's going to be tough for Tung Jian to win points from behind the table. But when she is back there, she keeps it deep near the baseline with topspin to help her chances.
Yeah, that wasn't the serve she wanted.
Unless you're referring to Tung Jian, then that was exactly the serve she wanted. Catches side edge. No, I'm pulling your chain. But yeah, Yuan Jianan, we've seen three times so far that the serve, the risk involved has, well, outdone the reward on three occasions that I recall.
That's another excellent start here for Tung Jian. Four unanswered points for the Singaporean. Wonder if this goes the distance today. First one.
They've all been so back and forth. It's easy for our imagination to go there right now, but still a long way to go in this game number four.
Longest rally. It's a wonderful backhand there from Yen.
Just when I was starting to think Tung Jian is not going to be able to win many points from back there, Yuan Jianan closes out perfectly down the line. Again, new table. But it was all painted and prepared before starting play today. But just adding the finishing touches there, Yuan Jianan.
5-1.
So that's the solitary point so far for Yen.
Five, two.
I'm sort of curious what's in the Infinity Lounge. I saw that there in the last shot. Like you got to know somebody to get inside. He's got a friend.
I'll hook
DJ.
You up. I'll sort it out. Yeah.
Okay.
4-6.
Taste of her own medicine here. Tung Jian going wide to the forehand, stretching Yuan Jianan, forcing her back behind the table a bit. Just 4 points between them now. Once again. Guess I should have said 4 points. She was increasing it, but now it's up to five, making that campaign for game number five, which would be the decider at this point. Quarterfinals and onwards, according to the WTT statement about best of seven
best
here.
Best of seven, yeah.
The Singapore smash.
8-2.
Her record, Tung Jian against top 20 players. She's only won 3 out of 17 matches. Tung Jian.
8-3.
Done well to get here so far, this far.
Another thing that's interesting out here about having two different surfaces, so different, like Yuan Jianan, the ball is very different coming in depending on which side of the racket you hit it with.
4-8.
So when you get a backhand from Yuan Jianan, it's going to spin, it's going to jump and kick up like it hit the edge of Tung Jian's racket earlier. And then the forehand, it's just a completely different bounce. So a completely legal towel break here at 12 points played in game number four. Good timing there, Yuen. An impressive receive there, steals it from inside the table. It was a good serve, but Zhang Jian wouldn't let you know that.
And now she moves to game point, six of them in hand. That's probably about right.
Ten-five.
Little question there. Zhang Jian saying, did that touch? Thought it did. Yuan Jianan saying, nope. Yuan Jianan is closer after all. I've been in that position, though. You think you hear something. You yeah. just want to check.
That's fair.
And
she's taken this fourth game. It's 2-2. Zhang Jian has level things. That's an aggressive start there from Yen.
On a racket edge as well, actually. Caught the top edge of the racket there from Zhang Jian. That's that fast, flat forehand from Yuan Jianan.
Until now, her biggest scalp, Zhang Yijing from Chinese Taipei. So world number six, this is Zhang Jian I'm talking about. That was at the Korean Open in 2017.
2-1.
Zhang Yijing just played the final last week in Goa. She's in outstanding form. Had a chance to see her earlier today, so lots of stars here. All the stars basically are here.
Yeah, this is the tournament they want to be at. Yeah, it's a roar from the crowd. They're going to try and do whatever they can to get behind the local favorite. That would be something, wouldn't it? For both the male and female player on the opening day of the Singapore Smash to win their respective matches against higher-ranked opponents.
3-2.
Definitely would be. Isaac Kwek already into the round of 32 in the men's singles. Yeah. Zhang Jian here in the decider, fighting for the same privilege.
Yeah, he was already the first Singaporean to win the main draw. Match.
The save from the middle, Zhang Jian. I mean, if I'm on Yuan Jianan's side, I'd be checking to see if it hit her shirt after this attack right into the middle. Perfectly played, as you could see in the replay. I guess good angle there for Yuan Jianan to see it clearly as well. Yeah. But nice upper body movement by Zhang Jian.
Yeah, did well to get that back. It's just going back and forth, trading points at the moment.
In case you're newer to table tennis, the reason they switch sides, when one player reaches 5 points in the deciding, the final game, in a best of five, that's game five, they try to keep it balanced. So no player has too much of an advantage on either side.
Five ball.
All level again.
The shot is just so difficult to predict. Again, with that short Pips forehand, much like Matthias Falk, if your shoulder doesn't say get as much range of motion as you might like, or your arm is maybe not as strong or fast there, it can be really tough to predict.
5-6.
Wow. And this comes in, who comes out on top there. No one has really been able to put on a run just yet in this fifth game. Change of serve here.
7-5.
Two clear, Zhang Jian.
And she's got the serves back on her side now again. This one a little bit more shallow. This is another trick that can be very effective to keep the ball low against someone who's hitting flat with short pips. If you spin it a little softer and keep it more shallow on the table, the ball doesn't come out quite as far nor as high.
7-6.
And she's Zhang Jian over the years, apart from Zhang Jing I mentioned earlier, she's beaten Michelle Lien and Miyu Nagasaki, Adriana Diaz, Lily Zhang, all along the way.
Not a bad list of names there to have in your pocket.
7-0.
Someone in the crowd certainly loved that.
Think it might be a coach for one of these two players. There's a lot of passion. I think some of the French coaches over the years, I think in Ma Lin as well, but it's funny, you've got Coach Molong for the LeBron brothers and Ma Lin for the Chinese women for some of them.
Oh, not the serve she would have wanted. Yan Tianan.
7-8.
Hit the side. But it all started from that serve.
I couldn't believe she survived that long on the point. Yeah, it sounded like net post on the final shot there. That's a look at the ball going right through the scoreboard. Just a reminder how tight this game is right now. The very business end of this match. Going dangerously net post indeed. Play a lot of table tennis, you get used to a lot of sounds.
As you said, she did pretty well to go that far in the rally.
Dangerous Yuan Jianan, still within 1 point.
Yeah, this is, it's sort of been timed perfectly that our tightest game so far is this fifth deciding one. And it's Yuan who's got that 1 point lead.
I mean, this next point is massive. To get two serves back and have two match points on your side, Zhang Jian's just hoping to tie it up.
Oh, okay. Zhang Jian up against it, did well. But it's Yan Jianan who's got match points.
Again, to keep these balls out of the net when they come in with such little topspin, you can see how much lift Zhang Jian tries to put on the ball and still it finds the net. It's just two completely different attacks, forehand and backhand. In case you're wondering where the sound came from, match points to the French, Yuan Jianan.
Oh, she's won that one beautifully. A very, very tight match, Yuan Jianan.